Hello.
I would like to introduce you MediOne TRQ 2022 Automatic Tourniquet Device. Automatic tourniquet devices are used to stop the blood flow in that limb by creating environmental pressures on the limbs through the cuffs, and thus to perform surgical applications without blood loss. This is how the product looks when it reaches you. Now, let's take a look at the contents of the box. When the device reaches you, there are 5 boxes in it. One of them contains auxiliary equipment. The other 4 boxes contain the cuffs. First, when we remove the cuffs boxes, we remove this auxiliary equipment box. There are 2 fuses, 2 hoses, 1 power cable, and user manual in the auxiliary equipment box. After removing the cuffs from their boxes, all the materials are now out of the box. Now we can move on to the preliminary stage. First of all, we insert the battery fuse into its slot. Connect the power cable to the device and the power supply, and turn the on-off switch on the back of the device to the on position. If we see that the AC power indicator in the lower right is green, it means that the connection has been successful. Press the power button on the membrane for 2 seconds to turn on the device. When turned on, it asks you a question about whether to perform software and hardware self-checking. If you want to skip, press the skip icon. For self-check, tap anywhere on the screen. Make sure that the hoses are not connected to the device while performing the self-check. At the top right of the screen are the AC and battery indicators. There is a date and time display at the top left of the screen. At the bottom left of the screen is the mute icon to silence alarms. The screen consists of 2 parts. The proximal part is colored red. The distal part is colored blue. There is a pressure gauge at the top of the screen and a time gauge at the bottom. The pressure range is between 20 and 650 mmHg and the amount of increase is 5 mmHg. The time range is between 2 and 240 minutes. There are 4 separate recording buttons for both settings. You can save the values you want to save by pressing the icons for about 5 seconds. Your values are saved each time the device is turned on. After entering the values you want to set, press the OK icon. The same procedures are valid for the distal section. Press the inflate icon once to inflate. Press the deflate icon twice to deflate for security reasons. Click the settings icon to enter the general settings. There are 8 different settings here. The first icon sets the alert volume. The second icon is used to set the device to give a warning after starting the operation, how many minutes before it ends. Even if the set time expires, the device does not automatically deflate these cuffs for safety reasons. The third icon opens the date and time settings. The fourth icon opens the screen brightness settings. The fifth icon changes the language of the device. The device has 2 languages, Turkish and English. When the 6th icon is clicked, 2 more icons appear. One of them is used for patient registration. By giving an 11-digit ID number, the patient can be registered and the last 5 patient records can be examined. The last 5 values applied to the patient are displayed with date and time. Lock icon shows the last 10 alarms given by the device with alarm codes. The 7th icon sets the key lock. If the key lock is enabled, The screen will be locked after 30 seconds if any of its proximal or distal parts are inflated. To unlock, press the lock icon in the middle of the screen and slide the icon to the right. The operating time of the device and the battery is approximately 20 hours and it contains a lithium-ion battery. The remaining battery value can be followed from the top right of the screen. You can enter the general settings while any of the proximal and distal sections are inflated. Turn on the IVRA icon to activate the IVRA mode. When the IVRA mode is active, the proximal and distant values are equalized. Medi One, we are trading for health.